Manish from second year MBBS, and I'll be continuing on the topic occupational skin diseases. Diagnosis of contact dermatitis. Verifying chemical allergy is usually done by skin patch testing, when minute doses of diluted substances are placed onto the skin and observed periodically. If an occupational origin is suspected, the general battery, which contains everyday sensitizing agents, should be supplemented by occupational series and or substances used at work. There are further diagnostic tests available: patch test with early examination, photo patch test, use test, prick test, intracutaneous test, and in vitro laboratory assays are less sensitive and specific. Tests identifying responsible immune cells are under research. Occupational acne. These are pinheads, papules, and pustules caused mostly by industrial oils and greases. Unlike common acne, the eruptions manifest at the site of skin contact. Tar derivatives and halogen-containing compounds may cause acne, just like certain pharmaceuticals. Who are at risk? Car mechanics, maintenance workers are at most risk. How to prevent it? Personal and work hygiene is of utmost importance in the prevention of oil acne. Frequent change and centralized washing of dirty workwear is necessary. Pigmentary disorders include depigmentation and hyperpigmentation. Depigmentation can be caused by chemicals such as hydroquinone, phenol, arsenic, and mercury compounds. It can also be caused by ionizing and ultraviolet radiations, as well as thermal or physical trauma. Hyperpigmentation can be caused by mineral oils, halogenated hydrocarbons, arsenic, and various pharmaceutical agents. Skin cancers due to chemical exposure. Pitch, tar, soot, anthracene, and compounds thereof, mineral and other oils, raw paraffin, carbazole, coal tar distillation products may cause a disturbance in the epidermis. This can trigger the development of basal cell and squamous cell carcinomas or conditions that may lead to these cancers. Arsenic causes brownish pigmentation and rough scaly patches. Bowen's disease, squamous cell carcinoma, and multiple basalioma may develop. Prevention of skin diseases due to chemical exposure. Proper workplace skin protection programs adapted to the actual situation are the best way to prevent occupational skin disease. The measures to be taken are as follows. The initial target is to eliminate skin contact with noxious material and wet work. Personal protective equipment, gloves, should be chosen according to the properties of the risk, taking into consideration the task, the work environment, and the worker. In order to minimize wet work, the duration of uninterrupted working of gloves should be minimized as well. National initiatives and sectoral guide may provide useful information for the implementation of a skin protection plan. However, it must be always tailored to the actual situation of the given workplace. Information and training of workers on exposures, prevention techniques, proper use of personal protective devices, and skin hygiene is of fundamental importance. Health surveillance is recommended in order to identify the shortcomings of measures and workers that need advanced protection. Support to the individual in maintaining healthy skin includes the provision of proper skin cleaning agents and skin rehydration products at the workplace. Thank you.